हैव अ नाइस डे। चलो तो स्टार्ट करते हैं। तो ओके, बिफोर स्टार्टिंग विद द लेक्चर लेट मी टेल यू, मतलब जो कल सौरभ ने पूछा था, व्हाट इज द बेसिक डिफरेंस बिटवीन द थैलासेमिया एंड द सिकल सेल एनीमिया। ओके, सो बेसिकली इफ यू ऑल जस्ट थोड़ा सा रिएट्रेट कि हम लोगों ने क्या सीखा था। इन केस ऑफ थैलासेमिया देर आर इधर डिफेक्ट इन अल्फा चेन और बीटा चेन, और इट कैन बी मेनली डिलीशन काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स जो होता है, मतलब कुछ तो थोड़ा सा पार्ट डिलीट हो जाता है। बिकॉज ऑफ दैट द प्रोटीन बिकम्स प्रोटीन बिकम नॉन फंक्शनल, मतलब वो अपना फंक्शन प्रॉपरली कर नहीं सकता या फिर उसका नंबर लेस हो जाता है। सो दैट इज अ केस इन केस ऑफ थैलासेमिया, जहाँ पे एक तो उसका नंबर इफेक्ट हो जाता है या फिर द प्रोटीन इज नॉट फंक्शनल बेसिकली। हाउएवर इन केस ऑफ अगर सिकल सेल एनीमिया, तुम लोग को याद है देर इज अ सिंगल न्यूक्लियोटाइड म्यूटेशन, मतलब सिर्फ एक न्यूक्लियोटाइड सॉरी सिंगल अमीनो एसिड म्यूटेशन। तो बेसिकली वहां पर सिर्फ एक न्यूक्लियोटाइड चेंज हो जाता है बिकॉज ऑफ विच द एंटायर कोडॉन चेंज। तो अगर तुम लोग को याद है ग्लूटामिक एसिड का हो जाता है वैलिन, जस्ट बिकॉज देर इज वन शिफ्ट इन देर इज वन चेंज जी टू ए टी समथिंग। सो बिकॉज ऑफ दैट द एंटायर जो हीमोग्लोबिन होता है, द नॉर्मल हीमोग्लोबिन जो होता है उसके उससे चेंज हो गया, इट बिकम दैट एच बी एच टाइप हीमोग्लोबिन। And this typical hemoglobin is actually abnormal hemoglobin. It is not a normal hemoglobin and it is having a lethal effect. However, in case of lethal effect in case of the homozygous condition. However, in this particular thalassemia case, that is not a lethal as such. Okay, there are problems. It causes anemia conditions and all those stuff hai. But it happens because hemoglobin is not sufficient. It is not functioning properly. That is a problem. However, sickle cell anemia case, it is completely abnormal hemoglobin. So I hope now it is thoda bit clear. The concept is same. Basically, dono mein bhi target protein, after jo protein affect ho raha hai, that is hemoglobin only. And we all know hemoglobin is important in different body functions like oxygen carrying capacity is there and hemoglobin is present on RBC. And so that's why agar hemoglobin properly nahi hoga convey or we can say functional, definitely different body functions will get affected. So that is a very basic difference and that's the same thing I think tumhare book mein waise hi mention kiya hai. Unhone wo typical aisa lateral and qualitative synthesis and also mention kiya hai, but it's like okay, ek mein the protein itself is abnormal, on other side ek mein there are some problem like ki wo kam produce hoga ya fir wo non functional produce hoga that way. So now I hope this is enough for you as a just
okay sir.
Yeah, there are many matlab agar tum log basically aisa normally even if you just search what is the basic difference between the hemoglobin between the sickle cell anemia and thalassemia, you will not find any aisa matlab major difference as such. Maine bahut check bhi kiya on online also, different papers also, as such is mentioned nahi kiya, but I think this is the way we can differentiate. So if you want you can check it out also. So that is fine and now let's move towards again the bioethics jo humne kal start kiya tha. So I hope you all understood what is ethics. Ethics hota kya hai? Ethics is typically a socially acceptable moral duties, conduct and judgment, like which is fixed hai ki okay aisa karna hai to aisa karna hai, these are the rules, so these are the rules you have to follow. That is typical matlab ek ethics se aisa we can bol sakte ki matlab theek hai, these are some common rules jo hum log follow karna hame follow karna hai because it is set by someone and we are following that. So as we mentioned ki it is not like ki aisa matlab international level pe standard committee ne aisa ye kiya vagera aisa nahi. Ethics is something matlab it depends from a person to person, also it depends from community to community, different groups to groups, matlab it depends why it is like that, because it can change with the different things. Kisi ka view of thinking अलग हो सकता है, किसी का perspective अलग हो सकता है, the thoughts and the way they conveyed can be different. So there are multiple reasons behind it. So that's why. But then ये सब होते हुए भी व्हाट दे ट्राइड टू डू, उन्होंने एक सेट ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड बनाया क्योंकि ऐसा क्या है जो मैक्सिमम लोगों के लिए कन्वीनियंट होगा और दे शुड फॉलो, एंड देन दे मेड दिस पर्टिकुलर एथिक्स थिंग्स. ओके, मतलब जो अभी हम लोग विद इन अ ग्रुप या फिर विद इन अ फैमिली या फिर विद इन अ कम्युनिटी जो हम लोग करते हैं, दैट इज एज हम लोग का नॉर्मल लेवल पे, लाइक एज इंडिविजुअल लेवल पे हम लोग करते हैं. बिकॉज दोज थिंग्स आर नॉट दैट इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर अस, क्योंकि मेरे घर में यही करना है, मेरे घर में वही करना है, या फिर मुझे किसी साथ क्या लाइक हाउ टू इंटरेक्ट विद अदर्स वगैरह. मतलब किसे दिस आर टिपिकल अपना फैमिली इश्यूज, लाइक ओके फैमिली लेवल पे होता है, होने वाला चीजें है. बट देन देर आर फ्यू थिंग्स विच आर एक्चुअली अ नेशनल प्रॉब्लम्स और अ नेशनल इश्यूज एंड विच रिक्वायर्स अ पर्टिकुलर सोल्यूशन, एंड दैट्स वाई अ टिपिकल गवर्निंग बॉडी इज देयर which has made us typical set of standard जो हम लोग सबको follow कर रहे करना पड़ता है, irrespective of कि हम लोग कौन से group को belong करते हैं, कौन से community को belong करते हैं, कौन से like whatever. So these are just a common information about the ethics. Then हम लोगों ने क्या किया था about the bioethics, क्योंकि as ethics is important in case of biology also ethics is equally important and rather it has to be keep in eye whenever we are doing anything. So we all know okay, bio means something related to life, and then there are different things which we had discussed, like in vitro fertilization is there, sperm banks are there, jo ki abhi currently hum log use kar rahe hain ya fir they are established in our country, and jiska like jisko govern kar raha hai, jis pe what you can say like we have to keep a control on them, because aise agar sabko chhod diya then there are high chances things they might misuse it or they can exploit the different things wagera, wo sab ho sakta hai. That's why we want to keep a watch or keep an eye on them, and for that reason this typical bioethics came in a picture. Okay, there are many laws which are also formed based on this ethics. So basically sex determination while during pregnancy is not correct ethically. It is not correct because otherwise what the female feticide ka chances badhta hai, and the people might like they generally as we know okay there are some misconceptions wagera ki boys chahiye girls nahi chahiye, and also those are things like now abhi in a current situation though the number of such cases has been reduced इतना नहीं है, but still there was a time कि मतलब ये सब problems were like at a peak. So at that's why ये सब like they have to have some restrictions or rule for it. Okay, नहीं करना है feticide, नहीं करना है abortion, and that's why then this is ethically not correct, and that's why they made this rule. Okay. To do a sex determination during pregnancy is illegal, and agar aisa kiya the doctor ne ya fir kisi labs mein, then they are liable to get legally sue for that, kyunki un log pe action liya ja sakta hai and liya jata hai rather. So that is a one example. Other example agar dena chahe to अभी मेरे को याद नहीं आ रहा है, बट ओके आई विल टेल यू, मुझे भी नहीं वो पढ़ा है बट आई डोंट रिमेंबर नाउ, बट आई विल टेल यू अभी मेरे को याद आएगा. सो दैट इज दिस वाज, बट आई होप यू अंडरस्टैंड कि व्हाट इज एथिक्स एंड व्हाई वी आर नीडेड बेसिकली. ओके सो या सॉरी आई रिमेंबर. सो बेसिकली अनदर एग्जांपल इज लाइक मेडिकल टर्मिनेशन ऑफ प्रेगनेंसी जो हो गया था, लाइक हुआ है, तो आई होप यू ऑल रिमेंबर व्हाट आई मतलब ठीक है. There is no point in saying. I hope I'm sorry for it saying again and again. The thing is, there is something called as medical termination pregnancy. मतलब क्या है कि sometimes कभी-कभी कैसे होता है कि particular female who is pregnant and having a baby, but then they found during some or other case because the baby is not in a healthy state or there might be some problems with the baby. So under such cases, up to a particular point. It is allowed that okay, the baby can be aborted for the betterment of the baby itself. मतलब ठीक है, because अगर it's better to not have the baby, and then for both the mother and the baby basically, because even the mother's life is in a risk at that moment. So in that case, they generally do such thing. But then they found that people again started using it, messaging it, because rather than using particular technique as a savior for such a complicated case, jahan pe actually requirement hai, people have started doing its misuse for some other reasons, and then they observe, and then they started doing it for like kabhi bhi, matlab, no matter is 5th month of the pregnancy, 7th month of pregnancy, or no matter what. And then they found that, because I hope you at least matlab itna sabko pata hoga ki jitna zyada late ye sab cases hota hai, utna zyada mother's life is at risk, because obviously the baby is connected to the mother in some other way. And it's just because ki matlab you are not happy with, okay, it is a girl child or it is a boy child, whatever the case is, but then, and you are forcefully doing a termination, matlab you are aborting the baby, so obviously it will have some implications or some effects on the mother's health also. And then at that time it was observed that many people were doing it, okay, matlab jab bhi unko samjha ki okay it is not something to unko chahiye waisa nahi hai, to they started abortion. And then they observed that ki matlab bahut sari females were like affected and unka death bhi hua tha at that time. And because of that, then they came to this rule that okay, there is a rule that after 3 months of pregnancy, no one can like abort a baby. So I think it is there in your reproduction chapter number 2. It is there. It's given in there. So वहाँ पे भी हम लोग discuss करेंगे whenever we do that chapter. But then the only thing is like कि मतलब ठीक है, it was started as a एक ये, and then it was then converted into a law, proper law. कि okay, not allowed to not allowed. तो देर आर स्मो मेनी सच थिंग्स जहाँ पे एथिक्स को कंसिडर करके देन उसको एक प्रॉपर प्लेटफॉर्म पे लाके देन उसको लॉ में कन्वर्ट कर किया गया. बट एट लास्ट व्हाट इज इम्पोर्टेंट, योर टिपिकल एथिकल कमिटी और गवर्निंग बॉडी इज इम्पोर्टेंट. आई होप आई एम क्लियर एंड यू आर एक्चुअली अंडरस्टैंडिंग व्हाट आई एम सेइंग. ओके, देन देर आर मल्टीपल लाइक एज वी नो बायोटेक्नोलॉजी का, इट इज नॉट अ सिंगल subject wise, it is an interdisciplinary field jahan pe hum log at a time multiple things kar rahe hain, matlab it's not only one field. So and as we are doing multiple field or multiple studies at the same time, obviously we need to have a proper regulations on this. So as I mentioned, in biotechnology there is something called as cloning, hum log karte hain, transgenic plants, animals are there, gene therapies are there, eugenics. Eugenics matlab different ways to improve a human life basically, matlab uska human proper isko affect karne, human species ko aur acha banane ke liye. So they will do some desirable like they will do some suitable matings and all those stuff karte, but which is also like a part of biotechnology. And then ye sab ke upar jo core topic hai, ye sab kiske waise ho raha hai, so the recombinant DNA technology. Okay, so as we are doing all these things, obviously there are different implications on the society. So even just kal humne discuss kiya tha about the problems with the golden rice. So if you get time and if you just go through like Google karoge, you will see there are different groups. One group which are like, okay, we support golden rice, and the other group, they are like, you know, golden rice is not having any properties, it is like not good for us, so ban golden rice. So it depends ki hum log usko kaise accept kar rahe hain, and that's why it is important. So basically whatever we are doing, and that's why biotechnology is taking a lot of time in India, because the ethical concerns like na matlab there are many. Kabhi it becomes community wise, kabhi it becomes religious, kabhi it becomes human rights ka problems, and then animal rights are there. Matlab whatever do you do, you have to have a proper permissions and all, and then you have to make sure ki tum kahin pe bhi stuck up na ho, ki okay your project should not get stuck up because of such problems, because the case, अगर कोई प्रॉब्लम हुआ, someone just filed a case against you, the case might go for years and years, but then you can't wait with your research for such longer time, and there are multiple reasons behind that, multiple people are involved in this particular process, so obviously generally we consider. But then as the at the above all is like a bottom line is like whatever we are doing in biotechnology as a research part of view, there are multiple views in a society. उसकी different implications हैं. So the reactions are like as a mixed reactions. So few individuals support it, few are not against it or protesting against it. So it depends, or it is based on only individual's own perceptions and the moral, like how the person thinks and what are his views or her views on the particular topics. So that's why this is a problem. That's why the biotech related problem, the things say, they are often very controversial and the frightening. मतलब उसके वजह से issues होते ही होते हैं. तो गोल्डन रेस का हो सकता है, बीटी ब्रिंजल्स का होगा, या फिर कोई ट्रांसजेनिक काउ का होगा. पीपल आर लाइक ओके एंड दे कैन लाइक समटाइम्स ना वी मेक अ इशू सच अ बिग ना द रियल इशू स्टेज बैक एंड पीपल स्टार्ट फाइटिंग फॉर देयर ओन बेनिफिट. लाइक आई डोंट वांट टू गिव एनी एग्जांपल्स राइट नाउ बिकॉज़ आई थिंक यू मस्ट यू ऑल नो कि देयर आर सच केसेस इन आवर कंट्री की मतलब जो मेन पॉइंट होता है उस पर हम लोग डिबेट चालू कर देते हैं, देन द पॉइंट वो रह जाता है बाजू में एंड वो लोग देन अपना ही कुछ तो नया, दे विल स्टार्ट सम पॉलिटिकल इशू, दे विल स्टार्ट सम रिलीजियस इशू एंड दे विल कीप ऑन फाइटिंग एंड द मेन एजेंडा और द मेन पॉइंट विल नेवर कम इन ऑन मेन लाइट और मेन इम्पोर्टेंस. इट विल नेवर गेट दैट इम्पोर्टेंस और दे विल नॉट ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज द मेजर पॉइंट और क्या उससे इम्पोर्टेंट फैक्टर्स है जिसकी वजह से वो इशूज क्रिएट हुए हैं. सो दैट इज अ मेजर प्रॉब्लम इन आवर situation in our country basically. But then obviously the situation is changing now, people are changing their minds and we are now more open towards the technology. So now all these things are there, but then why the issues are happening or why people are not happy with biotechnology? Kyun log ko issues karna hai? Acha khasa to hai, matlab agar maine acha cow banaya jo mujhe itna sara milk de raha hai, that is a good thing, mera economical fayda hi ho raha hai. Agar maine acche se प्लांट को मॉडिफाई किया वो खुद को पेस्ट से बच रहा है तो मेरा खर्चा बच रहा है, आई एम गेटिंग मोर प्रॉफिट. लाइक व्हाट एवर द बायोटेक्नोलॉजी इज डूइंग, इफ यू रिमेंबर डिप्रेशन आल्सो, वी आर डूइंग एवरीथिंग ओनली फॉर द ह्यूमन वेलफेयर, फॉर बेनिफिट्स ऑफ ह्यूमन बींग्स ओनली. एंड इफ अपना एजेंडा ही अगर वो है कि हमें अपने मतलब लोगों के फायदे के लिए कुछ ना कुछ करना है, देन व्हाट आर द रिजल्ट्स कि लोग आर नॉट हैप्पी विद इवन दैट थिंग एंड दे आर फाइटिंग और दे आर रेजिंग द कॉन्ट्रोवर्सीज about the particular topics. So few people have not happy ki okay jab bhi hum log animal model use karte hain jaise ki okay you are making the animals to suffer, this is not a good thing. Then why do you have an indication of species caused through transgenic? So matlab basically hum log ek jeans ek jagah se gene leke usko dusre animal mein dal rahe, usko combine kar rahe, this is like a not good thing na, you are going against nature, not a good thing. To jo jaisa usko waisa rahe log ka wo ek kehna tha. And again, transfer of human genes into animals and vice versa. मतलब okay, animal to human, human to animal. Generally, animal to humans का इतना नहीं है, but human to animals are very common because to study different genes in human beings ऐसा किया जाता है. So, but again, the problem is same. कि why do you want to eat animals and क्यों करना है तुम्हें ऐसे? मतलब you should find some other way. Obviously, there are no other ways currently known, but still. अभी मतलब as I said ना, अगर point raise करना ही है so without doing a background study, many people raise the points. We totally understand क्योंकि violations हो सकते हैं, the animal exploitation is a problem and all. But then one thing is there, the animals which are being used in a research are not something like कि वैसे कैसे भी हो कि आज मैंने घर पे दो कॉकरोच पकड़े, बस चूहे पकड़े एंड आई विल टेक इट टू द लैब एंड आई विल डू एक्सपेरिमेंट. नो, ऐसा नहीं चलता ना. हम लोग उसको एक्चुअली अपने साथ उनको ब्रीडिंग कराते हैं, खुद उनको पैदा करवाते हैं, फिर उनको यूज करते हैं. सो नाउ सच एग्जांपल्स और सच थिंग्स आर लाइक उनको परमिशन मिल जाता है एंड ऑल, दैट इज ओके, बट स्टिल द इश्यूज आर स्टिल देयर, सो इट इज अ प्रॉब्लम. देन पीपल आर लाइक अच्छा फायदा हो रहा है टेक्निक की वजह से, जस्ट एक्सप्लॉइट इट एंड दे जस्ट डू इनडिस्क्रिमिनेशन लाइक यूज ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी एंड वी पुट द एनवायरमेंट एंड द ह्यूमन हेल्थ एंड द बायोडायवर्सिटी एट अ रिस्क. तो नाउ ये कैसे रिस्क पे डालता है, दैट वी विल सी इन द नेक्स्ट पार्ट. बट देन आई होप यू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाई पीपल आर अगेंस्ट द बायोटेक्नोलॉजिकल यूज. फर्स्ट थिंग इज यूज ऑफ एनिमल कॉजेस ग्रेट सफरिंग टू देम. Second is violation of integration of species caused due to transgenation. Basically, violation of species there. Third one is transfer of human genes into animals and vice versa, which is not really acceptable by everyone. And the fourth one is like indiscriminate use of biotechnology pose risk to the environment, health, and biodiversity. Obviously, as we are doing so many changes at genetic level, there are some effects which are happening at on the environment, on our health itself, and also on a different biodiversity. When I say biodiversity, I hope you understand that it is a variety of different organisms present on the earth within a habitat. Kya different? So I can say that Western Ghat is having a very good biodiversity because वहाँ पे डिफरेंट टाइप्स के एनिमल्स से प्लांट्स से अल्गेस है लाइक वाइड वैरायटीज देयर सो द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ एनिमल्स और द प्लांट्स स्टेइंग इन अ पर्टिकुलर हैबिटेट वी कैन कॉल इट एज अ बायोडायवर्सिटी सो एंड द वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग फैक्ट इज लाइक कि देयर आर मेनी सच स्पीसीज ना मतलब जो हमें पता भी नहीं है कि वो एग्जिस्ट करते हैं करके एंड देयर आर मेनी सच स्पीसीज वो एग्जिस्ट करके दे आर गेट नाउ एक्सटिंक्ट आल्सो मतलब वो थे एंड नाउ दे आर नो मोर And still we don't have कैसा भी था भी and now we get to know about such species because उनके कुछ तो fossils या फिर some वगैरह remnants part are like कहीं कहीं तो मिल जाते हैं and then they start doing a back study कि okay ये ऐसा bone है तो ये किस कौन से animal का सकता है then they start doing some bioinformatics study and all and then they get to know कि okay this might be a type of animal जो कि वो time पे present होगा so these are just the Like different tools generally we use. Now, as I mentioned, okay, animal suffering is a one problem, and then environmental effect. But then there are multiple other effects also. कि जो problems create कर रहे थे in a biotechnological field. So what are they? So basically, the introduction of GMOs, that is a genetically modified organisms. Has led to a wider debate on a bioethical concerns affecting the social, economic, and environmental sphere. I think we already have discussed this. Look, it's not open. नहीं है. But look, there are say, I think now you all are in that state of mind. Now you can actually understand कि what is right and what is wrong. And उससे भी ज़्यादा, it is important to know कि each coin has a two sides basically. So that's the reason कि मतलब okay, हम लोग लोग से one side सोचते हैं एंड देन वी गिव आवर जजमेंट कि हाँ नो बीटी और लाइक बायोटेक्नोलॉजिकल प्लांट्स आर नॉट गुड दे आर हैविंग इफेक्ट्स दे आर नॉट गुड बट देन देयर इज आल्सो सेकंड साइड ऑफ द कॉइन व्हिच नीड्स टू बी असेस एंड टू अंडरस्टैंड कि व्हाई दे आर डूइंग ऑल दिस थिंग ना ऑब्वियसली इफ अ पर्सन इज स्पेंडिंग अ 10 टू 15 इयर्स ऑफ हिज लाइफ टू डेवलप अ प्लांट व्हिच इज गिविंग मी गुड डिजायर्स और गुड प्रॉपर्टीज सो ऑब्वियसली डोंट यू थिंक दैट कि जो लोग वहां पे काम कर रहे हैं ऑन द पर्टिकुलर प्लांट उन लोगों ने कुछ ना कुछ तो सोचा ही रहेगा दे मस्ट हैव डन अ गुड प्रॉपर बैकग्राउंड स्टडी क्योंकि प्रॉब्लम्स क्या है प्रॉपर्टीज क्या है कैसे इम्प्लीकेट होगा क्या इफेक्ट होगा वो नहीं करेंगे क्या सॉरी ऑब्वियसली दे विल डू दिस सर्विस बट देन डेफिनेटली एज आई मेंशन कहीं पे भी जो लूपहोल्स आर ऑलवेज देयर एंड आई एग्री इवन दिस टेक्नोलॉजीज आर हैविंग लूपहोल्स बट देन द लूपहोल्स आर नॉट टू मेक एन इशू Rather, there should be taken as कि how can we improvise more अगर कुछ problems है अगर कुछ allergies हो रहा है तो कैसे उसको हम लोग sort out कर सकते हैं so that is thing and I think allergies or such things are like very personalized thing मतलब अगर तुम लोग देखोगे कुछ लोगों को मतलब mushrooms खाने से allergy होता है but that's not like कि उसका पूरा family is allergic to mushroom no that only one person is having Like that, only that one person is not comfortable in eating the mushroom. So, उसके body पे कुछ reactions हो सकते हैं, वगैरह वैसे हो सकता है. Even some people even get affected because of the tur dal. Generally, it is a very commonly used dal in our food. But there are few people who actually get affected by this. Forget about the food part. Then, even the milk, there is something called as lactose intolerance. So, ऐसे लोग जो होते हैं वो lactose पीते हैं तो उन लोग को problems create हो जाते हैं उनके body में. They can't like take it in a good way. And milk is a major part. So even such cases are there, but these are not क्योंकि पूरा का पूरा community is affected or पूरा का पूरा one society का part is affected. No, it is like कि it is some very personalized. So if a particular person is not responding properly to a particular plant or particular effect, there might chances that the person's metabolism is not suitable for that particular product. So shayad the person is having some expression of genes ki jo zyada express ho gaye hai, and that's why it is showing such results. So that might be a reason. I'm not saying ki that are the only reason, but that could be a result. So these are such points. And obviously then agar nahi accept karna to obviously issues on the social level, economic level and environmental level. So then this includes the effects on a non-targeted organism. These are agreed because jab bhi humne suppose humne kuch herbicide bana diya तो जो मेरा टारगेट प्लांट है उसको भी इफेक्ट करेगा, एंड जो उसके बाजू में जो अच्छा वाला ग्रो होने वाला क्रॉप प्लांट से इवन दे माइट गेट अफेक्टेड. सो दैट्स व्हाई आई नीड टू हैव वेरी गुड स्पेसिफिसिटी इन एवरी एस्पेक्ट ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर टूल. देन इंसेक्ट रेजिस्टेंट प्लांट्स क्रॉप्स आर देयर, सो देयर आर लाइक कभी कभी ऐसा हो जाता है कि इंसेक्ट रेजिस्टेंट प्लांट की वजह से इवन द insects might show some different characters only, and then they become more aggressive or sometimes they just lose out, and there are different problems with that also. Gene flow is like, okay, we don't know ki matlab how which are genes are like getting activated, kaunsa we are losing the genes, kaunsa inactivated hai, wo sab baatein aa jati hai. And apart and all about this loss of diversity, so kabhi kabhi jaisa hota hai ki a particular plant completely get or a particular insect completely get extincted. So like we just don't know ki matlab wo gaya, because we are having interfering, we are doing some interference with the food chain or some other if properties of the food chain or the other matlab jo cycles hai yahan pe ye particular individuals involved hai, agar humne unko disturb kiya so obviously they might get extinct, and that's why it will lead to loss of diversity. And the major issue, matlab I think that can be a bottom line of everything, ki again the problem remains same, ki okay tum log sab acha kar rahe ho, you're trying to modify and all, you are giving us good properties and all, accept it, but still you are still interfering with the nature, you don't have that right, and that is a major problem in biotechnology. Isliye ki agar okay nature ne agar kuch bana ke bheja hai, it means ki शायद उसका कैपेसिटी उतना ही होगा, एंड बिकॉज वी ऑल नो नेचर इज द बेस्ट क्रिएटर, बेस्ट डिजाइनर एंड बेस्ट नर्चर. सो ऑब्वियसली इफ समथिंग इज एग्जिस्टिंग इन नेचर, देयर मस्ट बी सम काइंड ऑफ प्रॉपर्टीज और सम काइंड ऑफ लाइक बोलते ना मतलब हैज टू बी सम रीजन बिहाइंड इट, इज नॉट लाइक कि वो ऐसा ही, बिकॉज वी ऑल नो देयर इज समथिंग कॉल्ड एज सर्वाइवल ऑफ फिटेस्ट, मतलब अगर कोई तो इस पर्टिकुलर अर्थ पे surviving, it means that person is suitable and fit for surviving. Because agar koi fit nahi hai, to by the process of like matlab evolution or by the process of they get vanish off, matlab okay so death ho jayega ya fir they might suffer and they, but they might not reach the later stage of the life. So that is a one thing, and I think that is also an important fact to consider, because since the technology is available, there are actually few people who just started exploiting it and using it for not so good reasons, and that's the problem. And because of such people only, the issues are like becoming more prevalent. Okay, people are making more attention now. Okay, right? Problems, problems, problems. So that is the one thing. So I hope now you understand why people are making the issues. And then again, as I mentioned, ki there are some are doing which good work, and there are few which are not doing so good work. But then problems lies ki okay, because there were no such guidelines or there was no such rules ki what should be done and what should not be done using a recombinant technology. And because of that, everyone was using it with their own pace, with their own benefits, and with their
own like बोलते ना rules कि मुझे करना है तो मैं ऐसे करूँगा, and which led to a major problem. So this all led to a many bioethical issues, and which made it prominent. Okay, we need to have some particular guideline, which way se we can control it. Okay, so now we understood. Okay, क्या क्या problem से we understood what are ethics, we understood what are bioethics, and we understood why people are giving such concerns. Why these ethical issues are there.
So then animal rights are there, yeah, fir interfering with the nature is there, or diversity loss is there. So multiple reasons are there. But then now we've understood the problem, and then we will see ki actually so one of the problem was like there was some effect on the environment, health and all. So that we will see now. And after that hum log dekhenge ki अभी इतना सारा एथिकल प्रॉब्लम्स है तो उसको सॉर्ट आउट कैसे करते हैं, हाउ वी आर डूइंग ऑल दिस थिंग, मतलब उसको क्या हमने ऐसा किया है कि नाउ बिकॉज नाउ वी कांट स्टॉप यूजिंग बायोटेक्नोलॉजी बिकॉज द टूल हैज ऑलरेडी लाइक द फील्ड हैज ऑलरेडी टेकन अ बोलते ना बिगर जंप इन द फील्ड ऑफ रिसर्च एंड देन नाउ टेकिंग इट बैक इज लाइक रियली इम्पॉसिबल करंटली. सो वी सी नाउ व्हाट आर द इफेक्ट्स. So let's take the effect of the herbicide use and the resistance etc. So we all know ki matlab one of the very important development in biotechnology was to develop a insect resistant plant. If you remember, BT plants were the very common example of such thing, and which was like okay because the plant was used against the different pesticides or the insect, and it was developing a resistance to specific herbicides. However, the plant was showing very good food production, allowing farmers to use fewer chemicals and grow crops in a less than the ideal condition. But okay, it's not, they don't require a very high conditions and a high cost and all. So it was good, everything was going good. But then, if the amount or the herbicide amount of herbicide is increased, or the expression of genes which we inserted in a plant for insect resistance becomes like high over expression. Then definitely there will be having some negative effects on the plant as well as on the surrounding environment, and which is a major concern. And ये हुआ है because ऐसे होता कि okay मतलब we try to target one plant so that is fine, but कभी कभी ना वो plant के साथ साथ कोई और plant भी affect हो जाता है, even though it is not our target, we don't want to kill that plant, but still that plant gets killed because there is no specificity involved. और कभी कभी कैसे होता है कि मार रहे हैं, मर रहा है बट आफ्टर सम पॉइंट सम चेंजेस हैपन इन इवन दैट प्लांट एंड इट डेवलप्स अ रेजिस्टेंस. तो फिर बाद में हम लोग कितना भी केमिकल्स डाले, कितना भी कुछ ऐड करें, द प्लांट विल नॉट डाई, दैट इज अ प्रॉब्लम. सो बेसिकली सो दैट फॉर द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट सेज द अनइंटेंडेड हाइब्रिड स्ट्रेन्स ऑफ वीड्स. अनइंटेंडेड मतलब विच आर नॉट अ टारगेट also affecting, and other plants can develop resistance to this herbicide jo hum log use kar rahe kisi aur plant ke liye aur kisi aur weed ke liye. And why it is happening? Because there are chances of cross pollination ki matlab ek plant ka spores jayega dusre plant mein, and then there might be some effect exchange of properties which is possible, and thus this will have some negative effects obviously. And one such example is a Roundup. So Roundup is a kind of a pesticide or product is used to kill the different herbicides and all. It is a herbicide, sorry, Roundup is a herbicide, but then it was found that many plants are now resistant to Roundup. Okay, so that is one example. Then the other reason is like effect on the untargeted species in case of environment. So the very common example which they have given is the BT crops. So usme bhi the major one is the BT corn. Okay, which is produces its own pesticide, and BT products are actually in use currently. So if you all remember, मैं बताया था कि BT.
Hello sir.
हाँ.
Sir वो जो example दिया है Roundup, sir वो Roundup क्यों? मतलब वो जो क्या नाम है उसका वो herbicide है वो Roundup.
हाँ.
हाँ तो sir वो Roundup नाम क्यों दिया?
अभी वो नाम के दिया दैट आई डोंट नो, बट ये दिस इज अ हर्बिसाइड जो ग्लाइफोसेट बेस्ड हर्बिसाइड है. बेसिकली दिस इज अ टिपिकल पाथवे इन अ प्लांट. ओके, देयर इज अ टिपिकल पाथवे इन प्लांट. तो जब हम लोग ये हर्बिसाइड ऐड करते हैं, ये हर्बिसाइड के वजह से वो जो पाथवे रहता है दैट गेट्स अफेक्टेड और बंद हो जाएगा, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दैट दे विल स्टॉप द ग्रोथ ऑफ द प्लांट. बेसिकली ये बेसिक प्रिंसिपल है. अब उसको राउंडअप नाम क्यों दिया, इवन आई हैव टू चेक अप बिकॉज इवन आई डोंट नो कि वो ऐसा क्यों है, बट दिस इज अ ग्लाइफोसेट बेस्ड हर्बिसाइड दैट इज क्लियर.
ओके
या इट इज अ कंपनी आई थिंक फ्रॉम यूएसए कंपनी इज देयर मॉन्सेटो और समथिंग इज देयर जिसने ये बनाया था तो वी हैव टू चेक अप कि उसका नाम है सब बट वी विल सी ओके सो दैट इज अबाउट हम लोग देख लेंगे सो नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द अंटार्कटिक प्रोसेस का क्या इफेक्ट होता है तो अगर आई वाज सेइंग कि हम लोगों को याद रहेगा कि हम लोगों ने मतलब बीटी क्रॉप्स में वी हैड सेन कि देयर वाज सम स्पीशीज की जो अगेंस्ट द व्हिच कैन बी अफेक्टेड यूजिंग द बीटी क्रॉप सो देयर कोलियोप्टेरा डायप्टोरा वगैरह सब लोग था बट देन इट वाज ऑब्जर्व दैट देयर आर सम स्पीशीज व्हिच आर नॉट रियली ऑन द टारगेट लिस्ट ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर बीटी क्रॉप बट स्टिल गेटिंग अफेक्टेड एंड वन फॉर एग्जाम्पल इज the monarch butterfly it is a type of butterfly which is present in generally in the nature which has shown that okay this particular monarch butterfly is not actually a target for the bt pesticide or insecticide however it was still was getting affected due to the adverse effect of the bt crops on this particular insect or the pest and as it is not our target it was observed that this is just one example then there are many such species or the organisms which are actually getting affected because of unintentional effect matlab there are few species jo actually kaam ke bhi hai hamare liye which are actually helping us but still getting killed because of such effects and that's why the problems are there so it can also have some unintentional effects on a neutral matlab aisa species jisko kuch rule hai nahi na to wo harm kar raha hai na to wo fayda kar raha hai aur even there are some species jo ki fayda kar rahe unko bhi wo affect karte hain that's why this is one of the another important effect on the environment which is like the products actually affect the untargeted species also so I hope you understand what is the problem on environment Then that are the two major problems which we have seen, which are on the environment from a biotechnological point of view. Now, what are these particular products or the biotechnological facilities? What all problems these particular problems with biotechnological facilities or products are having on the human health? So the allergies, basically, the allergies which are kind of negative result effects you can say but then it is not like the all plants are showing as I said ki not all plants are showing all kind of people may allergies there are some specific group of people or some specific person who is actually showing the kind so you know what allergies and why it is affecting the human health basically so the GMO crops which were developed could show negative effects on human health because of which the consumers jo tune jisne bhi use kiya ya fir khaya hai have shown some unexpected allergies so one example is then so the researchers use a gene from a Brazil nut to increase the production of a methionine so methionine is an acid which is important as a supplement also so it is amino acid so they have done they have taken the gene from the Brazil nut and inserted into a soil. Okay, so they observed that the insertion of this gene in the particular soybean caused an allergic reaction to the soybean in those with known nut allergies. Matlab, because of the gene transfer from this particular Brazil nut to the So there was some, I mean, unusual kind of allergy which was observed in particular things. जो लोग ये खाया था and that was the one of the kind of allergies which they had reported. But then there are still like not like few people developed, people did not develop. So you know they are still studying it. कि ऐसा क्यों हो रहा है, what can be the reasons behind that and all. So let's see. And the बोलते हैं ना जो चेंज किया हुआ जो सोयाबीन का उसको लाइक जिसमें जीन इंसर्ट किया था दे कॉल इट सम बायोटेक सोयाबीन देन द अदर प्रॉब्लम इज लाइक लॉन्ग टर्म इफेक्ट लॉन्ग टर्म का मतलब क्योंकि किसी ने आज कुछ तो खाया है एंड द इफेक्ट कैन बी सीन आफ्टर फ्यू मंथ्स और आफ्टर टू इयर्स सो दैट कैन बी जनरली से लॉन्ग टर्म इफेक्ट ऐसा क्यों होता है बिकॉज कभी कभी ना कुछ चीजें अपनी बॉडी से मेटाबोलाइज नहीं हो सकती, मतलब वो ना अपनी बॉडी में डिपॉजिट होकर रहती है या फिर इट जस्ट सेल्स एक्युमुलेट एंड देन बाद में स्लोली स्लोली दे स्टार्ट शेयरिंग द इफेक्ट. बट फॉर अस लाइक एज दे आर नॉट शेयरिंग द इमीडिएट इफेक्ट, लाइक लेट्स टेक अ वेरी वेरी एग्जांपल, मैंने दो डब्बा आइसक्रीम आज खाया एंड आज टुडे इज लाइक 22nd of August और मुझे 22nd of October में कोल्ड हुआ, तो ऑब्वियसली आई कांट से ना कि मैंने दो एक महीना पहले वो खाया था एंड दैट्स बिकॉज़ आई एम नेवर इन दिस कोल्ड. नो, सो देयर माइट बी सम अदर रीजंस आल्सो, बट देन इन सम केसेस क्या होता है कि मैंने जो ऐसा प्रोडक्ट खाया कि जो मैंने खाया आज एंड सम हाउ इट जस्ट गॉट एक्यूमुलेटेड इन माई बॉडी, मतलब प्रॉपरली पूरा मेटाबोलाइज नहीं हुआ. And then, okay, जब मैंने खाया इट डिड नॉट शो मी एनी इफेक्ट्स as such on my body, मैंने कोई सफर नहीं किया, कोई सिम्टम्स नहीं दिखे. बट सडनली आफ्टर अ फ्यू वीक्स और फ्यू डेज मुझे स्टमकेश हो गया या फिर आई एम नॉट फीलिंग वेल एंड देन आई विल गो टू डॉक्टर एंड देन आई विल सी ओके माई ब्लड इज स्टिल हैविंग सम बोलते हैं सम अमाउंट ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर प्रोडक्ट जो मैंने बहुत दिन पहले खाया था एंड इट्स नाउ शोइंग इट्स इफेक्ट. ठीक है, ऐसा क्यों होता है कभी कभी इट टेक्स टाइम एंड कभी कभी बिकॉज ऑफ द एक्युमुलेशंस इट डेवलप इनटू डिफरेंट प्रोडक्ट्स, बाय प्रोडक्ट्स डेवलप होते हैं एंड दैट्स हाउ इट हैपेंस. हाउएवर दीज आर सम एग्जांपल, बट देन वी इन इफ वी गो दीज आर सम कॉमन एग्जांपल नॉट जस्ट रिलेटेड टू बायोटेक्नोलॉजी, बट देन इफ वी टॉक अबाउट बायोटेक्नोलॉजी द टेक्नोलॉजी इज स्टिल न्यू, बेसिकली इट्स नॉट दैट बहुत साल पुरानी है, ऐसा नहीं, इट्स स्टिल न्यू एंड ठीक है. इवन दो टेक्निक वॉज डेवलप और मैंने मोर लाइक लॉन्ग बैक लाइक आर डी एन ए वॉज डेवलप इन 1970 or 1975 के अराउंड पे तो किया रहेगा उन्होंने, बट देन द टेक्नोलॉजी बेस्ड ऑन द पर्टिकुलर टेक्निक्स आर कमिंग इन अ पिक्चर नाउ. नाउ पीपल आर डेवलपिंग डिफरेंट प्रोडक्ट, डिफरेंट ब्रीड्स ऑफ एनिमल्स एंड ऑल एंड विच आर अंडर यूज, सो दैट्स व्हाई नाउ वी स्टिल डोंट हैव एनी proper data to confirm that okay the product which we are using are having some long term effects. Short term effects obviously we are having short term effects ki pura research kiya gaya hai yani mein, but we are not really having the long term effect and that's why we cannot anticipate anything, like we cannot anticipate anything at this point ki biotech products ka ya gamers ka kuch long term bad effects hai ya nahi hai. Definitely with time we will get to know about these things, so let's see, wait and watch. Yeah, so then the next new protein, so basically proteins are the building block of a life, they are very important component and they are required for a variety of purposes. Enzymes are there, hormones are there, peptides are there, which are equal. But then few years back it was not there ki okay agar koi mere body mein kam hai so I will inject it. No, that was not that option was not available. One only option was which was available to you. Kisi ka agar protein ka deficiency hai then doctors will say ki ha protein rich khana khao. It's a beans, pulses वगैरह खाया करो, so that you will just overcome the protein का जो problem है या फिर low level of protein in body that can be solved out. But then if today we are having a problem with the protein, I think we have a lot many supplements available जो कि directly हम लोग खा सकते हैं, inject कर सकते हैं, not through a different types of food, but only a concentrated protein which can give a direct effect. So such the such proteins are now available and which can be taken directly, but again as of now the potential effects on the human body are as of yet unknown. As I mentioned, kiya hai. However, if you check online, there are few things you can get to know. Ki matlab okay, there are few studies ki unhone aise bola ki no, this is not safe, or there are things jinhone bola ki this is very good of working. So obviously there are mutual or mixed reviews on such things. But officially, as they are mentioned, there are no such effects that then food additives. Okay, so what is food additives? Food additives like introducing new nutrients into foods and giving some extra properties. So एक single plant में या फिर single food material में I would like to have a different composition. So उसमें protein source है, carbohydrate source है, lipid source, vitamin source and all. So this is a possibility which is like working well, but then it was also observed that कि मतलब अगर as we all know हम लोग additional supplements तो कर सकते हैं food का, that is one good thing. Also we can provide antibiotics and vaccines also via the food, so which is also a good thing. But then it was observed that this availability of this technology that जरूरत नहीं है उसकी, उनको भी वो मिल मतलब वो मिलेगा. एंड इफ दे आर गेटिंग इट सो देर विल बी प्रॉब्लम बिकॉज इट विल लीड टू अननेसेसरी रेजिस्टेंस. सो बिकॉज इफ दे आर नॉट सफरिंग फ्रॉम एनी डिजीज दे विल रिसीव सच कंपोनेंट्स एंड देन द बॉडी माइट रिएक्ट इन सम अदर वे than a normal. So that can be the possible case and that's why it is very important to know specify क्योंकि अगर मैं कुछ food provide कर रहा हूँ तो ये बोल तो कितना level देना है, कितने amount में देना है और किनको देना है. It's not like कि मैंने एक universal biotic product बनाया and now starting from the newborn to the 90 years old individual सब लोग खाओ, कितना भी खाओ, मजे करो. Not like that. So it is not that typical Chyawanprash time thing, koi bhi khao swasth raho aisa nahi. So definitely depending on the age, depending on the sex, depending on the different body characters and the bolte na typical pattern of living, this particular things can affect a typical individual. So all these things needs to be considered before we take any step ahead in the particular field of adding different nutrients or the antibodies or the antibiotics or the human health. So we have seen kitna char allergies ho sakta hai, long term effects ho sakta hai, new proteins ka problem se ki effect pata nahi hai hum log ko, and same pruritus ka it can develop resistance to the people who don't require it. So abhi itna some effects hai, even environment mein bhi effects hai, there are so many ethical issues also. As I mentioned, someone need to take a stand now ki okay, how say so technique ko band karke aur just withdraw karke in from use kuch fayda nahi hone wala hai. We have to have something jo usko control kar sake, we can decide ki kya karna hai aur kya nahi karna. Jo ki humne dekha, there should be something which will be which will decide what should be done and what should not be done. So for that, in terms of GMO, the Indian government has set up the Genetic Engineering Approval Committee, GEAC. Please don't forget it, this is important especially for native people. Okay, so Genetic Engineering Approval Committee, they make decision regarding the validity of the research involving GMOs and addresses the safety of GMOs introduced for public sale use. So agar mujhe GMO banana hai to first they will say ki kyu karna hai, kis liye karna hai, what are the requirements, what are the organisms being used, kiske liye bana rahe hain, wo which will be target animals or which will be target humans, uske applications kya hoga, wo sab study kiya jata hai. So if you remember maine jab bataya tha ki if mujhe koi research karna hai in my college only, still I have to go to first professor, then my HOD, and then my college co authority. Then from college authority it goes to the next stage at a state level, then at a national level, and finally it gets approved basically. Depending on kis level ka research ho raha hai. There are different such bodies which are now in place. There are different research institutes also which are making. So basically, let's say ki okay, I am a ICMR fellow. So ICMR is the Indian Council of Medical Research. Matlab they are the one of the research body in our country. So every year they provide support to most of the research in their PhD work or in their research projects. But jab hum log unko apply karte hain or they ask them for help,
वी आर सपोज टू प्रोवाइड देम विद ऑल द प्रॉपर डॉक्यूमेंट्स एंड आई हैव टू मेंशन कि जो मैं रिसर्च करने वाला हूँ उसमें एनिमल मॉडल्स यूज होंगे या नहीं होंगे. सॉरी, अगर यूज होने वाले हैं तो कौन से टाइप की होंगे कि ओके विल इट बी रैट और इट विल बी माइस और इट विल बी गिनिया पिग और समथिंग यूज और रैबिट. अगर ये सब यूज नहीं हो रहे और मैं यूजिंग यूज कर रहा हूँ और मेरा तो ठीक है, अगर यूज करने वाला हो तो हैव टू गिव अ प्रॉपर रीजनिंग एंड प्रॉपर अप्रूवल. क्योंकि अगर मैं यूज कर रहा हूँ तो वो मैं कहाँ से प्रोक्योर करूंगा, मैं उनको कहाँ पर नर्चर करूंगा, मेरे पास वो तो फैसिलिटीज है या नहीं है और हु विल रेगुलेट माय वर्क एंड ऑल. एंड टाइम टू टाइम मुझे उनको आफ्टर एवरी सिक्स मंथ और आफ्टर एवरी ईयर आई हैव टू डू देम अपडेट कि हाँ मैंने ये एनिमल यूज किया है, मेरा रिजल्ट ये आया है, मैंने वो किया है, मुझे वो मिला है वगैरह. बिकॉज दे हैव टू कीप एन आई. ऑन अदर साइड अगर मैंने कुछ ऑर्गेनिज्म डेवलप करने का कोशिश कर रहा हूँ तो आई हैव टू डेवलप सम लेट्स से बैक्टीरिया जिसमें जिसके पास कुछ एक्स्ट्रा ऑर्डिनरी प्रॉपर्टीज होंगी. सो व्हाट आई विल डू, आई हैव टू राइट टू देम क्योंकि मेरा क्या आइडिया है, मेरा क्यों करना है और व्हाट कुड बी द पॉसिबल सिग्निफिकेंस. आई थिंक नाउअडेज सिग्निफिकेंस इज बिकम अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट वर्ड एंड रिसर्च इज नाउ बोलती ना गेटिंग there is typically a revolution in a research field now because of the significance word. Because bahut log kaam kar rahe the, they are doing a good research and all, but then the government was now more keen towards doing a research which is a application based research just jiska kuch to kuch fayda ho sake, jo ki mainly USA mein ya fir Germany mein era hota rehta hai. So now we have to be a part of that race and definitely we will be successful. But वो कब होगा? When we will be having such committees, some bodies in our country which will be working towards the safety and the proper regulations towards research. So GEAC is one of the important committee which controls all such activities with respect to genetic engineering. So I hope you understood what I said till now. Okay, if any doubt is there, you can ask. No, then I will just explain you what is patent and we will stop for a day. I think within next lecture I think we will be done. So let's hope, let's see case work out. So the last two topics of this chapter includes biopatent and biopiracy. So today we will just start patent. I will tell you what is patent. तुमने सुना भी होगा कभी ना कभी कि अरे ये साइंटिस्ट को ये पेटेंट मिला या फिर तुम्हारा अगर कोई फैमिली मेंबर्स होगा जो रिसर्च में होगा सो इफ दैट पर्सन इज डूइंग सम वर्क दैट नहीं वैसे कि हाँ मेरे कॉलेज को इतना पेटेंट्स मिला है, मेरे लैब को इतना पेटेंट्स मिला है. और नाउ इफ टू डेज बैक ओनली आईआईटीज का लाइक आईआईटी बॉम्बे, आईआईटी मद्रास एंड आईआईटी दिल्ली थ्री इंस्टीट्यूट्स लाइक बेस्ट इंस्टीट्यूट्स इन अ रिसर्च कंट्री. सो एक ऑन व्हाट बेसिस जैसे है कि कौन सा कॉलेज और कौन सा इंस्टीट्यूट डूइंग वेरी गुड और व्हाट आर दे डूइंग. सो बेसिकली पेटेंट इज वन ऑफ सच एक्टिविटी जो मोस्ट ऑफ द रिसर्चर्स आर प्लानिंग और वांट ऑलवेज वांट. दिस इट इज अ लाइक काइंड ऑफ डिजायर और ड्रीम फॉर एवरी रिसर्चर कि लाइफ में मेरा भी एक हाथ पेटेंट होना चाहिए करके. सो नाउ लेट्स सी व्हाई वी आर सो कीन अबाउट दिस पेटेंट. व्हाट इज पेटेंट? सो पेटेंट इज अ स्पेशल राइट granted to the inventor by the government. So if मैंने कुछ invent किया है so government will say कि हाँ ये जो invent किया गया product है that is invented by Tejas and Tejas will only have the whole rights to use it and to exploit it for his benefits. And if someone else want to use Tejas product then they have to take a proper permission from a Tejas and then they can use it. If Tejas denies to do the permission or use the permission, they cannot use it. If they do so even after denying the permission, then they are liable to the legal action. So unpe action liya ja sakta hai. On other hand, a company comes to me and gives me a very good offer ki tum apna product hame bech do and I will give you a good amount of money in return of that. And if I'm happy with that deal and if I'm having a kind of contract, okay, to what extent they can exploit it and all, those all things are there obviously. It's not like I will completely गिव इट अवे कि हाँ ले ले भाई नो नॉट लाइक दैट बट इट इज अ टिपिकल कॉन्ट्रैक्ट विच हैपेंस देन दैट कंपनी कैन यूज इट फॉर देयर बेनिफिट्स गिविंग प्रॉपर क्रेडिट टू मी ओके दिस इज अ टेक्नोलॉजी और अ प्रोडक्ट डेवलप्ड बाय तेजस एंड वी हैव टेकन इट फ्रॉम हिम एंड दे विल पे मी एंड दे विल ऑल्सो गिव मी अ नेम क्रेडिट ओके दिस टेक्नोलॉजी वॉज डेवलप्ड बाय हिम So all these things, ये सब होने के लिए we need a proper platform. अगर ऐसे हमने ये देखा घर में तो nobody will like at a like normal level, nobody will pay give any बोलते ना कोई हम लोग entrepreneur नहीं करेगा कि हाँ ऐसा करना है बोलेगा अगर नहीं जाके बोला हाँ ये मैंने develop किया ये मेरा है तो people will not take me seriously. That's why I need a proper platform and then patent I think use the right platform. So that's what the patent says. Patent is a specific right granted to the inventor by the government. It is a property of the inventor. So it is right of the inventor, it is a property of inventor. And that's why only the inventor can decide ki what should be done with the invention. And as I mentioned, it can be sold like any other property and for the benefits. And it is mainly consist of three important points like grant, which is nothing but agreement with the inventor, specification, which actually describe what is the subject, why it is like what is the particular invention related to, two important and all, and then claims, see what can be the application, maybe product, like say, ye ho sakta hai, wo ho sakta hai, this can be the possible thing and all that can be. So very best example. So Raghunath Mashelkar is the person who had fought a lot like the bolna a typical scientific war we can say because America ne patent liya tha based on turmeric and they claimed that ki turmeric is having very good properties wo anti inflammatory hai wo wound healing hai matlab usse injuries heal ho sakta hai not But just tell me, abhi at this moment, you are cutting a vegetable while listening the lecture. तुमने मेरा lecture सुन रहे हो. At the same time, तुमने अपना हाथ cut कर दिया by mistake, and it's bleeding like a lot. बहुत ज़्यादा bleed हो रहा है. Without taking a minute, your mom or your anyone from your family will come running. ऐसे भाग के आएंगे with the haldi in their hand and they will put it on your that injury or jahan bhi cut hua hai wahan pe and I think almost everyone like hamare abhi this particular class is some 46 students and almost everyone will agree with this ki ye hoga and why this no kuch kisko pata tha ki ye thermodynamic is having some properties because my mom tell me my mom's mom tell her her mom tell her and this is like traditionally from one generation to next generation वो पास ऑन हो रहा है हो रहा है हो रहा है इट मीन अ लॉट मेनी इयर्स बैक बहुत साल पहले किसी ने एक्चुअली वो इन्वेंट करके रखा था कि यार टर्मरिक इज हैविंग सच प्रॉपर्टीज एंड यू टू ऑल नो इंडिया इज हैविंग अ वाइल्ड हिस्ट्री ऑफ आयुर्वेदा वी आर लाइक नोन फॉर अपना आयुर्वेदा इन ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड हम लोग का जो आयुर्वेदिक मेडिसिन से आयुर्वेदिक प्लांट्स है दे हैव टेकन अ लॉट ऑफ अटेंशन नाउअर एंड ये सब होते हुए भी दिस अमेरिका दे क्लेम दैट हल्दी इज आवर प्रोडक्ट और हम लोग का पेटेंट है मतलब कल अगर मुझे हल्दी के बेसिस पे कुछ कंपनी स्टार्ट करना है इन माय कंट्री आई हैव टू गो टू टेक अ परमिशन फ्रॉम अमेरिका कि ओके नॉट इन माय कंट्री आई एम सॉरी इफ आई एम गोइंग टुमारो इन अमेरिका आई गॉट सेटल्ड ओवर देयर एंड अगर मुझे अमेरिका में कुछ नया प्रोडक्ट चालू करना है So I have to go to the country PTO, the patent office, and I have to take permission from them. कि जो हल्दी हमारा ही है, जिसके properties भी हमने study किए थे, उसके लिए now I have to take permission from someone else. And that's how the problem started. And America started exploiting it for their benefits. उन्होंने उनका companies वगैरह start कर दिया, and they were using it. This is our product. Even though So obviously it affected apna economy aur apne people ka benefit and that's why Raghunath Mashelkar came in the picture and he actually फाइट अ लॉट फॉर दैट पर्टिकुलर थिंग एंड देन फाइनली उन्होंने प्रूव किया कि नो टर्मरिक इज नॉट अ अमेरिकन थिंग इट इज अ इंडियन प्रोडक्ट एंड इट इज द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ इन दैट वे उन्होंने वो जो राइट्स था टर्मरिक का वो वापस लिया एंड नाउ इंडिया इज होल्डिंग अ पेटेंट ऑन अ टर्मरिक सॉरी सो आई हैव यू अंडरस्टूड व्हाट आई सेड That's what the patent meant, and that's what the power of patent is. Na powerful hota hai koi patent ko. So I recommend that please read about the turmeric patent, and then we can discuss in detail about it in detail. Also, we will also, but just to give you background, I told you the story right now, but hum log again wo discuss karenge in detail. So I hope you understand what does I mean by patent. In next lecture, we will discuss what is biopatent, and then we will start the topic of biopiracy, which is the last topic for this chapter. And as it is the last topic of the chapter, I recommend all to read and comment. Come in the next class because there will be the quiz session. I hope you all remember. मैंने कहीं बताया था कि there will be a quiz in the last lecture. तो जितना भी मेरे आगे हमें ने cover up किया है. तुम लोग को पढ़ के आना है सो प्लीज रीड अप एंड कम वी विल बी हैविंग अ क्विज इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास सो थैंक यू सो मच हैव अ नाइस डे वी विल स्टॉप हियर ओके कुछ डाउट्स होगा तो तुम लोग पूछ सकते हो